My fat story started out as an idea that I would put on weight and lose it again to prove essentially that fat people are lazy. So I started out deciding I'd put on nearly half my own body weight and then lose it to show that I'm not lucky to be skinny. Actually, if I sit on my ass and I shove half the fridge in my face, then look, I get fat too. Being overweight is hard. And before I even started, I put on a rucksack with 4 stone of potatoes to see what that would be like. And I walked along a beach. And that's hard. It's hard work. Anybody carrying more weight than they should be, it's tough. Getting through a day is tough and it's tiring. But I think more importantly, there was a much more emotional journey that took over. You know, I learned what it's like to lose confidence. I learned that not being able to run for me took away everything that makes my days okay. And I learned what it's like actually to stand at the back door and not want to go out because you feel ridiculous. You feel that people will point at you and you feel like you don't fit in. So I used to say to people, oh, for God's sake, put on a pair of trainers and go for a run. And I kind of learned that when you're fat or you feel fat, that is not what you feel like doing at all. A lot of larger people were talking to me about the fact it wasn't until the day they caught their reflection in a shop window, or someone maybe showed them a wedding photo and said, oh, look, a wedding photo. And they saw themselves and thought, oh my God, those were the day, the kind of day of dawning when people go, this has got to stop. I'm going to change this. I'm not going to be this person. And that's really the first step. For me, the first step of fat story is recognizing you have a problem and owning the problem and deciding that actually you're the person that's going to do something about it.